Hello everyone, on this video I'm going to show you on how to add our access control board into our WatchNet Access integrated security system software. So after you install the software, the first thing that you're going to have to do is go into setup, then go into communication configuration, and then go into communication tab. So look for host IP address, and by default you'll see it by 0.0.0.0. So this icon right here, once you click it, it will grab the IP of the computer, whatever the IP of the computer is set. If it's on dynamic, it may change. So just keep in mind, we suggest that you always put the computer on static if it's on the network, so it doesn't change. Or you can reserve that IP on the router, so router doesn't give them a new IP address. If in case the controller is not connected to the network and it's just connected directly into a computer, what you can do, you can set a static IP on the computer and then use a sample static IP, and then use that for the meantime to connect the controller. So for now, we're just gonna click that, and then that's gonna be the IP of the computer, and then we click OK after that. The next, we have to go into controller configuration. Here you can click the search button at the bottom, and then we click the net button beside the 0.0.0. so when you click the net button, it will automatically search the network for all available controllers. So we'll connect to this controller right here, for example. What you could do is you can click auto config. And if it's not configured with the same range, the software will configure it automatically. And then it will also put the host IP of the computer at the bottom when you click the auto config. Okay, once you're done, you click OK. And you should see a message at the bottom saying parameter successfully. After a few seconds, you should notice that the controller will appear on the background under search and upload controller. What you do is close this TCP IP setting window, and then you check the box on the right hand side under ID, and then you click save. Once you click save, the controller will be added at the bottom, or sorry, at the back, and then you should see it there with the connection check. Okay, so you can close the window, and then you can see the board on the left hand side under access tree. Okay, and then you can see all the components for that controller. Alright, so that's how you add the controller. It's very easy and quick. So yeah, you can also check our other videos on YouTube, and then you can learn from all the configurations. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.